Blackstone Publishing presents Green Fraud: Why the Green New Deal is Even Worse Than You Think, by Marc Morano. This book is read by John McLain. Foreword. On the day the new Green Deal was announced, I was en route to a TV appearance with Tucker Carlson and did a bit of perfunctory Googling in case it came up. The FAQ sheet declared the deal's commitment to, in its words, fully get rid of farting cows and airplanes. Which would be bad news for me, as I always travel with a flatulent Holstein as my emotional support animal. Go on, try it. 20 minutes out of LAX, you'll have the first-class cabin all to yourself. And then, I forgot about it, assuming that it would be just a bit of, if you'll forgive the expression, red meat for the hardcore loons that fellows like John Kerry, the flatulent bovine of the climate conference jet set, would toss out at Davos black tie galas of the Committee for Transnational Gas Baggery. 6 months later, I turned the page of my newspaper and was confronted by a photograph of German cattle attempting to graze while wearing what appeared to be metal lederhosen. They had been fitted with these awkward contraptions by scientists anxious both to measure and to contain the poor beast's flatulence. And you guffaw and pass on to the sports news, forgetting that, in today's world, no one who matters is laughing. Not Joe Biden, not Justin Trudeau, not Leonardo DiCaprio, not the sainted Greta. They're deadly serious. No pilot program is intended to remain such. If they can put flatulence lederhosen on a cow, they can put them on you. I regret to say that my old chum Boris Johnson, a man who once breezily waved away the subject of global warming with the words, "It's all bollocks," seems exactly the sort of chap to mandate flatulence lederhosen for residents of designated Tier 3 COVID lockdown zones. Unlike most of us, Marc Morano doesn't laugh and move on. We face a malign alliance of politicians who follow the science and scientists who follow the politics, and he takes them as seriously as they take themselves, and possibly more so. I have had the pleasure of interviewing Mark a few times on TV, and he is every booker's must-get guest on this topic: trenchant, forensic, effective. His enemies grasp that, in 2019, a peer-reviewed study in a prestigious scientific journal found that Mark ranks as the number one climate contrarian on the globe. If the oceans really do rise to swallow Barack Obama's and Barbara Streisand's waterfront property, and the planet fries, and the lone surviving Homo sapiens on Earth are floating on an ice floe with a couple of emaciated polar bears circa 2031, as Representative Ocasio-Cortez predicts, one of them will surely use the last bars of his dying cellophane to pull up that prestigious peer-reviewed hit parade and curse Morano's name to the heavens as they melt into the inferno of the broiling waters. What an honor. Mark should put it on his business card. Take a look around. Politicians and activists who can't save their state or county, town or school district, instead claim to be able to save the planet. The Green New Deal is their ultimate omnibus spending bill. It asserts jurisdiction over every aspect of life, which is to say, every aspect of you. At their Monday night poker game in hell, Hitler, Stalin, Mao, and Pol Pot must be laughing their socks off. "Oh, we're only doing this to save the planet. Why didn't we think of that?" Marc Morano is the perfect guide to pierce through the fog of bovine flatulence and delineate the green new world they're planning for us. Mark Stein. Chapter 1: The Green Raw Deal. What should people know about the Green New Deal? The Green New Deal is the ultimate wish list of the progressive environmental agenda, and it has nothing to do with science or saving the planet. The Green New Deal would impact literally every aspect of your life, from your light bulbs.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.